Hello friends, in this video we will understand how to develop the circuits with the help of decoder. For this video we have taken an example of full adder and we will see how to implement full adder using decoder. Let us begin. To implement full adder, first of all we should know the full adder thoroughly. So for full adder, ABC are inputs and sum and carry are outputs. So what I have done, for all possible combination of ABC, I have already written from 000 to 111. So let's write their respective sum and carry for all the inputs. When inputs are 000, of course sum is 0 and carry is 0. For 001 input, sum is 1, there is no carry. For 010 again, sum is 1, there is no carry. For 011, we know that 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1. Therefore, sum is 0, carry is 1. For 100, sum is 1, carry is 0. For 101, again there are 2 ones, it means sum will be 0, carry will be 1. For 110, of course sum is 0, carry is 1. And for 111 combination, we get sum 1 as well as carry 1, right? Full adder we have already seen in detail, but just to implement full adder using 3:8 decoder, the preliminary knowledge of full adder should be clear. Now for my reference, what I am doing is, I am just taking all decimal positions for all possible combinations of ABC. So for 000, you have decimal position 0, decimal position 1, decimal position 2, decimal position 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. They are already in sequence, right? Now to go ahead, I'll write equation for sum, which is function of ABC, and I'll write their respective min terms. With 3 variable you get 8 min terms, because with 3 variable you got 8 possible combination. Every combination gives you 1 min term. So of course there are 8 possible min terms, but then not all of them come at output. In output only those min terms appear for which output is 1. Therefore, as you can see, sum is 1 only for 1, 2, 4 and 7. Therefore, I can write it is 1, 2, 4, 7 and this is equation for sum. As well as for carry also we need to write a similar equation. So carry is also a function of A, B and C. So only those min terms comes out for which carry is equal to 1. So as you can observe, carry is 1 for 3, 5, 6 and 7. So I can write 3, 5, 6 and 7. So before you implement any circuit with the help of decoder, first step is to get the output equation in terms of its min terms. So once you get this, then it becomes very easy to implement it. So here we are going to implement full adder using 3:8 decoder active high output type. So to implement it, we will recall the functions that we have obtained in the previous slide. We had equation for sum, which is function of A, B and C, which is equal to summation m 1, 2, 4 and 7. Whereas for carry also, we have function of ABC, it is equal to summation m. The min terms were 3, 5, 6 and 7. So the first step is to implement for sum. For sum, as you can see, there are min terms 1, 2, 4, 7. So what we will do is, we will take those respective outputs together, which is 1, 2, 4, 7 for sum and 3, 5, 6, 7 for carry. So first of all, we will see for sum. So let's take 1, 2, 4, 7 together. So what I have done is, I have taken 1, 2, 4, 7 together in order to implement the function for sum. You have to do very simple thing, just connect OR gate and whatever the output is, now that output is considered to be sum. At the end, I will justify how this figure has come and how this figure is really working. Next, what you have to do, you have to implement the similar function for carry also. It doesn't mean that you need a separate decoder. Within the same decoder only, you can implement carry also. So carry is a function of ABC where min terms are 3, 5, 6, 7. So output number 3, 5, 6, 7 you will take together, and again you will connect as an input of OR gate, and output of OR gate will be considered as carry. It is that simple to implement a full adder with the help of decoder or any other circuit with the help of decoder if the function in terms of main term is known to you. So 3, then we will take 5, then we will take 6, as well as we have taken 7 from here. So these 4 lines have come out. Again I am connecting with OR gate, and OR gate output will be considered as what? Carry. So let us justify whatever circuit that we have drawn over here. We need to justify the same circuit again. So how do we justify this? It's very simple. Now suppose we consider ABC input as, let's say, 101. According to 101 combination, you should know what should be respective sum and carry. If you apply input as 101, of course sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. Forget about full adder. Consider as if this is only 3:8 decoder, and accordingly try to get the output. With 101 combination, what happens is only Y5 becomes 1 and other Y0 to Y4 and Y6 to Y7 are equal to 0. So here only Y5 become 1. Y5 becomes 1 means only output with decimal position 5 equal to 1 and rest of the outputs are equal to 0. So as you can see, for gate number 1, which is giving you some output, 5 is nowhere connected to some OR gate. Am I right? Therefore, sum remains what? 0. So sum remains 0 since 5 is not input of sum. In fact, input of sum are 1247. And only output number 5 is active. Out of 1247, all of them are equal to 0. Therefore, the value of sum equal to 0. At the same time, since if you refer carry function, it has got one of the input is equal to 5. And that output number 5 is equal to 1. The property of OR gate is that when one of the input is equal to 1, output is 1. So this time you get carry equal to 1. Similarly, it works for all the combinations. Let's say if I apply input as 001. If I apply input as 001, it means 001 gives you sum equal to 1 and carry equal to 0. So for 001, if you refer, Y1 becomes 1 and rest of the outputs are equal to 0. As you can now refer, since 1 is a part of sum, then sum becomes 1. Am I right? At the same time, as you can see, only output which is Y1 is equal to 1 and other outputs are equal to 0. So as you can see, 1 is not included in carry function. Am I right? Y3, Y5, Y6, Y7, since all of them are equal to 0, which is responsible to give you carry, all of them are equal to 0, results into 0. Therefore, carry remains 0. So this is how this circuit works. But this is applicable for full adder by using active high type 3:8 decoder. Am I right? Suppose if it becomes active low type decoder, then connecting OR gate is not allowed. Then what needs to be done, that we will see in the next slide. So in the next slide also, I'm actually trying to develop full adder by using 3:8 decoder but with active low type output. Therefore, first of all, let us recall the same relations, which is sum is equal to, it was function of ABC, and it were having min terms as 1, 2, 4, 7. And for carry, which is also a function of ABC, min terms were 3, 5, 6, 7. Am I right? This time, instead of using OR gate, we use NAND gate, and otherwise all other things are exactly same. So I repeat, in case of active low type output, you have to use a NAND gate instead of OR gate. That's the only difference. Otherwise, the whole implementation remains same. So 1247 output I will be taking together for implementing some function. So as I have shown, I am using a NAND gate and NAND gate output is now considered as sum. Now let's develop it for carry also. For carry, we will take Y3, Y5, Y6 and Y7. Along with that, Y7 is also needed. So I can see this Y7 line. I can take Y7 connection from here also. Now I'll connect it to NAND gate, and the output of NAND gate is nothing but carry. So this time, instead of using OR gate, I have used NAND gates, but let me again justify how it works. For example, input we are considering is, let's say, 110. For 110 input, what output you supposed to get? Of course, sum is equal to 0 and carry is equal to 1. Now 110 activates which output? In 3-to-8 decoder, when 110 input is given, Y6 input gets activated. But don't forget, this time it is active low type output. Therefore, Y6 becomes 0 and all other output remains 1. So consider only 6 is equal to 0 and all other outputs are equal to 1. All other, as in, when I am talking about sum, in sum, Y1, Y2, Y4, Y7 are outputs taken together. So Y1, Y2, Y4, Y7, all of them are set to 1. Since all of them are set to 1, can I say that all the inputs of NAND gate is equal to 1? The rule of NAND gate is that when all the inputs are set to 1, output is 0. Remember, that's the rule of NAND gate. When all the inputs are set to 1, output is always 0. And this is the same sum I'm looking for. That sum should become 0 for 110 combination. At the same time, can you see that for 110, since Y6 bar is equal to 0, and you know what, 6 is one of the minterm of carry. So can I say that one of the input of NAND gate now becomes 0. In NAND gate, when one of the input is fixed to 0, output is always 1. This is exactly inverse the way AND gate works. In AND gate, when one of the input is 0, output becomes 0. Here exactly reverse happens. When one of the input is fixed to 0, output is becoming 1, irrespective with the other inputs. So therefore, this is how it works. Now the question is, how do I come to know that I have to use a NAND gate here instead of OR gate? That I am going to justify in the next slide. See, in active high type, what we have used is OR gate. Am I right? In active low type, use which gate? NAND gate. So when I'm using NAND gates or a NAND gate here, for simplicity, let me just take two inputs only. Let us assume only A and B. So with A and B input, you get a standard equation as A dot B bar. And what you get over here, let's say with only two inputs A and B, we'll remove the third. What output you generally get? Y is equal to A plus B. Don't forget, when I'm using OR gate, inputs of the OR gate are active high type, whereas inputs of the NAND gate are active low type. If you remember, active low type means they are bubbled. It means, can I say, they are bubbled input. So they are bubbled input NAND gate. So bubbled input NAND gate, what really happens is, input is not A and B now. Input is individually A bar and B bar. Therefore, instead of getting A dot B whole bar, what you get is Y is equal to A bar dot B bar whole bar. Am I right? Don't forget, in NAND gate case, that is in active low output type case, outputs were not Y0, Y1, Y2. They were in terms of Y0 bar, Y1 bar, Y2 bar and so on. Therefore, I have not taken input as A and B. I have taken inputs as A bar and B bar. Therefore, it is A bar dot B bar whole bar. By De Morgan's theorem, A bar dot B bar whole bar is A double bar plus B double bar. Ultimately, Y is equal to what? A plus B. So don't forget that your bubbled input NAND gate is equivalent to OR gate only. Your bubbled input NAND gate is equivalent to OR gate only. Ultimately, you are doing the same thing. Since inputs of the gate are now becoming active low, so as to remove that effect, we have used a NAND gate. Ultimately, the effect is OR gate only, right? Thank you.